Tonight, the state of the lake, a major new report. The risks facing Lake Champlain aren't going away. Good evening, I'm George Mallet.
I'm Stephanie Gorin. Despite lots of public attention in recent years, progress remains slow in addressing many of the key problem areas up and down the 120-mile lake. Critics say today's report shows the need to do more.
On the Environmental Beat, News Channel 5's Stuart Ledbetter joins us live in Burlington with the story, Stu.
Well, George and Stephanie, the state of the lake, it's mixed, and progress in key areas remains painfully slow. This is a detailed and very readable new study, the first in a couple of years from the Lake Champlain Basin Program, and it affirms where we are now on everything from water quality to risks to human health.
In a new report on the health and risks facing Lake Champlain, there was good news and bad.
Most of Lake Champlain is in very good overall condition.
The Lake Champlain Basin Program's State of the Lake report, the first since 2008, found the top problem remains phosphorus. Not from municipal wastewater treatment plants, the study said they're doing the job. It's coming from farm fields and parking lots, especially after storms. Pollution runoff responsible for damaging weed and algae growth. For longtime activists, frustrating to hear.
We're still using our waterways and our water bodies as a repository for waste.
Major flooding last year didn't help, and the impact of climate change is full of unknowns. Since the mid-60s, the report said, August lake water temperatures on average are up almost 7 degrees.
At least 49 invasive species are now known to be in Lake Champlain, and many more are right on its doorstep.
The report details progress and challenges facing the 5 different segments of Lake Champlain, and there is some progress. Lamprey controls, for example, are working.
There are isolated spots, but overall, the main lake is definitely much better than it used to be.
Water chestnut harvesting is keeping more of the South Lake clear, and mercury levels in 3 popular sport fish are falling.
New York State has produced a remarkable success story through the cleanup of PCB contamination in paper pulp sludge in Cumberland Bay.
What the report does not quantify is the economic value of a clean, usable lake, which some think is in the billions. So still, environmental groups like the Conservation Law Foundation said today's report amounts to a careful, accurate record of the lake's decline, showing the need for what they called serious regulatory action. The Environmental Protection Agency was in Grand Isle today. They are now drafting new phosphorus limits for the lake and said they will use the report for guidance. The full report is now posted on WPTZ.com. In the newsroom tonight, Stuart Ledbetter, News Channel 5. George?
Thank you, Stu. Well, researchers say they have found the invasive spiny water flea in Lake George, just the latest New York waterway invaded by this tiny predator.
Today, the DEC says an angler at the north end of the lake pulled in a batch of fleas last week and samples taken on Tuesday. A task force of New York and Vermont authorities is working to stem the spread of the flea.
Now, on Monday, Vermont Senior Senator Patrick Leahy called for closing parts of the Champlain Canal to protect Lake Champlain, a move that was largely rejected by New York officials.